61 people have tested positive for coronavirus on the quarantine cruise ship docked off the coast of Japan, including now 11 Americans. This number is alarming because this is 40 more cases than we reported just yesterday. CNN's Will Ripley spoke with passengers on the ship, including an American woman who now has the virus. He joins us live from Japan. Will, I have to say, the huge jump in these numbers in one night is a cause of enormous concern.
It is, John, and we've been speaking for a couple of days now with passengers on board the Diamond Princess. We've been asking them to take videos and send them to us, which we've showed you. And once the news broke that the number of cases tripled overnight from 20 to 61, well, the whole mood changed. People are very concerned, saying that this ship behind them, which now has the highest concentration of coronavirus patients anywhere in the world outside of mainland China, is starting to feel like a floating prison. Another day on the Diamond Princess under quarantine.
Looks like they're unloading additional passengers.
Another day confined to their cabins, counting the ambulances, counting the number of coronavirus patients as it doubles, then more than quadruples.
We were looking out our balcony and there are indeed more ambulances lining up like they were yesterday.
Americans Kent and Rebecca Frasure never thought they would be on one of those ambulances until a Japanese nurse knocked on the door.
We need you to get ready. We don't know how long you have to stay in the hostel.
Pack the luggage, go to the bathroom, and then stay in the room.
Rebecca's throat swab came back positive for coronavirus.
I don't really have any symptoms, you know, other than a cough.
The news is a shock to their family and friends in Oregon.
What's the hardest part?
I'd say the unknown. Like, I don't know what's going to happen an hour from now, tomorrow. Like, for all we know, we could stay quarantined on the ship for a month.
Passengers say they can only go outside in small groups under close supervision for less than 1 hour a day. For them, this luxury liner is starting to feel like a floating prison.
We're in a contaminated prison, possibly.
Florida passengers Gay and Philip Quarter are among the lucky few with a balcony. Many of the 2,600-plus passengers are in cramped cabins, no windows, breathing air circulated throughout the ship.
This is not a safe environment, and we don't think anybody, let alone the Japanese government, wants to be responsible for making a bad decision about quarantining us in an unsafe place.
The Quarters are in their mid-70s. They know the vast majority of coronavirus deaths are people older than 60. And she says the Diamond Princess is packed with retirees.
We want off this ship and we want to go in health and not in dire medical circumstances.
She even has private insurance that covers crisis extraction. But the Japanese government says they can only be extracted after the 14-day quarantine period. And no word on whether the 14 days begins from the first reported case on February 1st or the latest. They hope the U.S. government will do something to intervene and bring more than 400 American passengers home. We learned overnight that President Trump spoke with the Chinese President Xi Jinping. One of China's main complaints is they feel the U.S. is sort of overreacting here. A lot of U.S. airlines have canceled flights to mainland China altogether. But given the fact that there are now more than 31,000 cases and 600 deaths, the U.S. feels there's certainly reason to be concerned. And that concern is felt very acutely by the people who are on that boat behind me, Poppy.
Wow. Stunning to see and hear from them, especially that woman, as she found out that she had contracted it. Will Ripley, thank you for being there and for your reporting. So the global death toll from coronavirus has grown now to more than 600, and the number of confirmed cases now tops 31,000. This comes as we learned that this man, this is the doctor who blew the whistle, who first warned Chinese officials months ago about this outbreak and how deadly it was. Our David Culver recently spoke with the doctor. He joins us now live from Beijing. I know this is someone that you and your producers have been tracking and talking to for a long time.
Poppy, and what you begin to realize here is this is not a guy who wanted the attention. He didn't want to be a hero. He's simply somebody who early on, back in December, saw this and said, let me tell my friends about this, sent it through a group chat. Somebody screenshotted it. It went viral. His name was attached to it. It got him in a lot of trouble. Police essentially pulled him in Wuhan and said, shut up, go back to work, don't talk about this. And he points out to us, he was one of several people who went through that, one of several whistleblowers early on. And then going back to work, he contracted the virus. He got sick. The same virus that he was trying to warn people about ended up taking his own life. It's an incredibly tragic story, and it almost sounds like something out of a movie, except you're reminded this is real life. As you point out, this is somebody who we were speaking with and in contact with for the past couple of weeks. My producer, Young, who's in the studio here with me, he had a connection with him and felt that he had won his trust, too, because he spoke to us, foreign media. That is hugely profound. That doesn't happen very often and very easily. He knew the repercussions that could have come from that. And yet, his story has also resonated with millions of people here in China. It is exploding on social media. And you have not only the dissidents and the activists who are speaking up, you have ordinary folks, and you have police and other officials who are united in this rare moment saying, this is somebody who should have been listened to and things could have been very different, John.
All right, David. David Culver for us in Beijing. Again, David, thank you so much for the work you're doing there. Please stay on this because this appears to be getting worse or bigger than we thought even yesterday.